Welcome back to Let's Interactively Play Sorcery. I am the RPG Chick, and once again this is a Let's Play where you get to choose at the end the outcome of what we will be doing next, at the beginning of the next video. I only had 2 votes last time, which is pretty much becoming the norm, or is the norm. 1 to 2 on this 4-sided die will indicate we're dropping down to the street on the wall we're sitting on, so dropping back down to the street, never mind the house or whatever's inside, and we're just going to continue heading back towards the north gate like we've been doing. And a roll of 3 or 4 will be dropping to the other side and checking out the house and whatever else there is there. So, throw. 2. We got 2. We're dropping down to the street, heading back for the north gate. Okay. Dropping back down to the street. Moving on down the road. Time to move on. Okay, so trying to make our way back to the north gate. And I want to ask Mulas here if we can get back again. If we see Mulas knows the second... Oh no, Mulas is the... That's where we went out. It's Korga who is here, so we want to ask Korga, the idol inside this temple, if he or she or whatever can tell us the second half of Mulas's spell. You follow the road as it narrows. The houses built up against the cliff face become narrower too, with single buildings divided and divided again until each dwelling is no wider than its own doorway. Now we're still looking because someone else might know the other half of this spell. Or spell line. You pause to knock on a random door. After a short pause, it opens to reveal a thin woman wearing a bright blonde wig. She seems surprised to see you. Who are you? She demands. Who sent you? No one sent me. Then what do you want? She folds her arms crossly. Am I looking for a priest? Why am I looking for a priest? I'm looking for the city nobles. At least it's kind of similar to what I want to ask. Well, you won't find him here. A little out of my league, so to speak. I'm new in Kharé. What should I do? She laughs bawdily. You're asking me? Here's what you should do, honey. Keep one hand on your money pouch and the other on your sword and never turn your back for a moment. She nods behind you with her chin. Turn around quickly. You spin round. This Finn woman laughs and slams the door. We didn't lose any money. Well, this leads back to Fireview Square. We've been in Fireview Square quite a bit, so let's walk on this way. Have we seen these bunch before? The road turns and heads roughly southeast once more, but you have been spotted. A group of young orklings are scurrying towards you. Hurry to avoid them? You increase your stride, hoping to breeze straight past, but the gang is big enough for them to easily block the road. You are soon right in their midst. Their hands poke at you and push outwards, hoping for a donation. Yeah, I remember. I've been doing that. I got away with a gold piece, didn't I? You toss a gold piece down the street. The orklings fall about themselves immediately, squabbling over it. Let's leave. What? You gently move the orklings aside so you continue along your path, but despite your gift, the little creatures are crowding in close, their hands mauling at your backpack. They're trying to steal from you. Threaten them with a curse? Get off me all! Curse your souls, you declare. The orklings back off a step. One chews his lip with an oversized tooth. Have I got a soul, then? He asks his friend. How much would it fetch? The little pests press and push in on all sides. One is trying to climb up your back. Let's see what kind of spells we can cast. What's available? We got dud, illusionary gold. I like that one. What else we got? Foff, which is force field. Gob. Conjure goblins. We need a goblin's tooth. I don't think we have. Oh, dud is the illusionary gold. What else? I guess. I have a T? Telepathy, right? Read mind, yeah. Illusionary gold, yeah, dud. Doesn't require any components, so. Illusion of treasure. You cast a spell and piles of gold and treasure spill from the sleeves of your jacket and all over the road. The orklings go instantly into a frenzy of collection, running over each other and beating each other up, stuffing handfuls of gems into their tunics. You take the opportunity to slip away. Good one. Continue up the road. This is, what's his name's mansion? You continue up the road, leaving the chattering orklings behind. After a short distance, you come across a large building made of stones and mortar. We've been there. Lorag. It is Lorag. Continuing on. The road continues on between dense houses on either side, when suddenly you begin to smell a sharp, acrid smell. Burning. Looking up ahead, you see a column of smoke. Is the district on fire? Right, right. The blacksmith. I'm not going to read all this. We've been through this. You guys want to pause? You can read it. Don't see you there. Northgate spell. Wolf armor. He's been the boss for a long time. Vic, that is. This is, I think, 20 gold pieces. That's right, 40. Alright. Continuing. There's that pedestal we stole money from. Tempted, right? What do I have? The giant worked last time. Two sun jewels, right. We did find one. Now I got two sun jewels. That's awesome. Yeah, I was wondering about that last episode. We found that at the end of last episode on top of that wall. We need the other half. So annoying. Well, not even timing right. I guess we're in like, what, 10, 15 minutes, something like that? Well, where do... Yeah, we'll go all the way up and around. Got it. We've been in all these places. Oh, the well should help us with our stamina. Gold piece? Maybe whoever this is can help us with this. You flick the coin into the well and wait for several seconds before you hear the plop as it hits the water. The well is clearly very deep. The voice sings out again. Throw down one more coin for me. Two wishes will I grant for thee. One more. You throw another gold piece down the well. The voice returns. Thank you for tossing down your wealth. For one more coin, I'll grant you health. What kind of spell would I cast? Two wishes. Okay. I have not heard my fortune. I have not been granted any wishes. Even if I could get health, I'm pretty close to full already. So I'm kind of pissed I've lost out on 2 gold now. It's half my wealth. Oh, can we do this again? Illusionary? Just out of curiosity, yeah, I think I'm gonna do it, but S-U-S, right? Detects trap, best possible action. This is a telepathy spell, T-E-L, which would be cool, but we need a skull cap. We do have a skull cap, don't we? And M Mag, protection from magic. Quicksand. Oh, I meant to click on that. Thank you. You cast a spell creating a mountain of gold and treasure, which you tip into the well piece by piece. The voice inside begins to sing deliriously, giddy with excitement at so much wealth. After a few minutes of this, a hatch opens in the side of the well house, which you had not noticed before. A tiny gnome clambers out. He reaches down into the well, unclips a rope from one side, and attaches it to the pulley, and then begins hauling up the bucket. Ask him what he's doing. "What are you doing?" you demand. But the gnome appears not to notice you. It seems he is blind, and maybe deaf as well. He continues to wind the pulley until the bucket reaches the surface of the well. All the water inside is drained away through holes in the base, but there are some gold pieces inside. The gnome tips these out into a pouch. I'm grabbing it. Nice, I got my gold pieces back. Along with a giant's tooth. Nice! That's for our giant summoning spell. Sorry, reading ahead, guys. You reach down and snatch the pouch from the gnome, who jumps almost out of his skin, and then scarpers for cover in the well house once more. In the pouch, you find your gold pieces along with a giant's tooth that someone must have thrown in by mistake. Cool, so we broke even there. And the necropolis, which we've been through many times before. Read all this before, so we're just going to go through. Hoping Kharé can help me. Everything is dead, but nothing is still. Oh, crap. So we had to look at the stones instead? You have no intention of wandering between the stones, especially when the path is so clear. You continue along the way, curving between ancient trees and listing stones. Then suddenly you hear a deep moan and a rattle of chains. Something is clouding the air in front of you. It is a Death Wraith. This land is cursed for the living, the Death Wraith moans, raising its ghostly spectral arms and holding out bony fingers. You must become dead. I think I ran for it and died. I don't think I ever tried fighting this thing. I mean, maybe it would be okay, but... I'd rather try a spell. Gak? Fear spell. I think it's gonna be immune. Wait, we have a U, yeah. Gum, which is... web. Not gonna work against the spirit. Walk? Where's walk? Metal shield, which costs a gold piece. Wall? Invisible wall. I think I might have tried that and it didn't work. Against a spirit, not sure if it's this one. Dumb is the control. Where is that? Control animals and stuff, I believe. Oh. Drops it. Make an enemy drop an item, actually. Sorry. N. I. Nif. Oh. Nauseating stench, but you need nose plugs. I've never seen that one before. Did I do H? Huff? I'm not sure how useful any of these spells will be. Seriously. I'm trying to find Huff here. I'm not familiar with that one. Gust of wind. We need a gale horn for that. That's a fireball. Anything else? Tea? Telepathy. Probably gonna die and I'll rewind, but... We have a... Wait a second. Let me just make sure we have a skull cap. I mean, there's ineffectual and then there's stupid, so... Why am I drawing a blank here? Yeah. Cloth skull cap. I do not want to become dead. Would be cool to see what he's thinking, though. Or it's thinking. You put the skull cap on your head and cast a spell, reaching out to the dead wraith's mind, but you find nothing there, only the empty desolation of death and the life beyond. The endless emptiness and soul-crushing despair that makes you want to collapse, to decay, and fall to the ground. Quickly, you pull the skull cap from your head, shaking. The mind of a Death Wraith is a terrible place. You ready your sword and strike at the Death Wraith, but the blade passes straight through. Of course, only silver weapons can harm a specter. Try the silver chain? I'm curious, though. I just want to see if I still have the skull cap, if it's still usable. Yes. So I have a silver chain. Oh, from the chain maker. The net? Or is this in treasure? No. Oh, it's a weapon. Right. Silver chain. Thinking quickly, okay. You dig up the chainmaker's silver chain instead and wind it about one hand. The death wraith grins and leers closer. I'm gonna defend this time. Good move. The death wraith drifts forward, one hand reaching for your neck, the other holding its blade aloft. It howls with icy rage as it approaches, knife outstretched. You gather your wits and drop into a defensive crouch. You turn most of the blow, then adjust your grip and try to settle your nerves. Oh, damn it. Then the death wraith is at your throat. You are wide open, chain drawn back, and you are wide open again. It stabs out violently. You stagger backwards, clutching at the bleeding wound. Your blood colors the dirt floor. It reaches out with long skeletal fingers. I will come for your blood. I will suck you dry. Never! I didn't have to do that as hard. The chill of the graveyard is all around you as you seize the moment to strike. You charge forward. You cut across his cruel blade, and the wraith moves between the headstones. The death wraith does not bleed, but seems to flicker. It leans forward with crooked hands. Your heart will be mine. It will stop. I'm going to defend this time because I don't have energy. Yeah, should have just hit. You stretch the chain between your two hands as the death wraith reaches out with its skeletal hand. Something dark flutters across your face. Oh crap, I'm not doing well. The death wraith grins with pleasure as it comes for you. Your own attack is thrown aside. It wails and screams as it lowers its blade down into your neck. You stumble and fall. The wraith grins its bony teeth. It can smell the approach of death. It reaches out with hooked, bony fingers. I can taste your life. I am hungry. Defend. I'm not doing well. Every time I defend, I don't have to. You drop back as the death wraith leans toward you with its bony grip. You breathe out heavily. That just barely beat me there. Ooh. Then the death wraith is at your throat. You are vulnerable. Yes. And you're exposed. See, that time it says something. I forget what it said. It said something twice. The death wraith seems to grow stronger with every injury you suffer. You are bleeding badly, but the creature does not seem to tire. It leans forward with long hands. Well, it's not getting stronger, but I am getting weaker. If I defend, I'm gonna get 1 point. You ready your chain to strike, finding the wraith's thin form. You lash the death wraith with your length of chain. You move above his dagger. The death wraith shimmers for a moment, its skull mask seeming to slip. Nope, dead. You will try again. The death wraith grins with pleasure as it comes for you. It lashes out wildly. The death wraith jeers and laughs as it plunges its sword deep into your heart, then turns the hook blade up to enter your skull from below. Oh, crap. But still you do not die. Not until it reaches you with a skeletal hand and gently pinches close to your throat. Well, at least it was gentle at the end. Alright, defending. And cool artwork, huh? Oh man, why? Okay, defend. Oh, I didn't have to. I'm gonna have to attack hard for this. Nope. Yeah, I'm gonna do it again. Again and again and again. You ready your chain to strike, finding the wraith's thin form. You make a quick lash. You move above his dagger. The death wraith shimmers for a moment, its skull mask seeming to slip. You secure the chance to attack. You slash the Death Wraith with the chain. You cut across his curved blade. The Death Wraith is growing paler and more gray. You are injuring it. I'm gonna do it again, too. Shameful. You prepare your chain to attack, connecting with the creature. You charge forward. With a final strike, the creature wails and moans and seems to vanish in on itself. The air is suddenly a little warmer. Gonna do it again, because I don't want to have... Would I end up with three? Now, he always charges forward with this strong attack. And then whatever I did the second time wasn't enough. I think I did side swipe, so I'm gonna do cut. God damn. 3 points? Am I defending this time? I forget where I am. Yeah, I guess that's a good idea. Oh, man. Nuh. You stumble and fall, yeah, etc. I can taste your life. I am hungry. Well, too damn bad. Aw, man. Doing it again, guys, just so you know. Crap. Nope. Yeah. Dead. Am I defending the second round? I'm gonna do thrust because I can't seem to get that attack in. Damn, still! Ugh, and it takes 3 points for me. It takes a lot of points, that's what it is. Oh, I should've gone. This is sucking. Okay. I'm just gonna get to the end of the battle and I'm gonna do it over again because this is ridiculous. Two or three points every time is ridiculous. I either have to defend this time, or I have to make a really strong blow. We have cut, thrust, and then lunge and charge. How about thrust? Good. So I just barely beat him there. So now I'm defending. And I shouldn't have. If I'm going to attack this time... Thrust again. Good. Ah. Then the Death Wraith is at your throat. Your own attack is thrown aside. It stabs out violently. So, now I take my turn, because that was another attack. Okay, there. Good. Okay. The Death Wraith is growing paler and more gray. You are injuring it. I will come for your blood. I will suck you dry. defend. Oh man. Do I dare cut? Damn it, I should have. I guess we'll have to deal with this. You hurry back onto the path before the creature can rise again. In the fields of the graveyard, you see other specters rising from the earth. What? Out. Pull up the bucket, right? Drink. Good. I'm done with throwing coins in buckets, wells for now. Going back up to Temple of Kurga. Was this here before? To the left, the track gets narrower still. To the right, a massive shadow looms, so large it seems as though a colossus has seated itself on the wall in thought. A chill wind blows through you as though ghosts walk back and forth this way. Look at the shadow. Oh. Oh, the shadow's to the right. Just a ziggurat. Okay. Going back up to S. Korga. Dropping a gold piece. You slide a gold piece into the gargoyle's mouth. For a moment nothing happens and it appears to swallow, and next it opens its stone eyelids to reveal two crisp and beautiful eyes. Looking... Well, that gave me more stamina. I had 9. Sweet. Looking into the gargoyle's eyes fills you with a sense of calm and peace. The eyes close after a moment, but the sense of well-being remains. Or did you just imagine that the gargoyle moved? We're gonna keep, yeah. Should I eat something? At last, away from the rats and night foxes that live on the ground, you are free to eat. You take out the last of your provisions and eat it quickly, feeling better for both the nourishment and the rest. The wind claws at you, trying to pull you to earth. Point of light, if you've seen this before. Are you like a lion or something? Oh, we gotta fight the friggin' snake again. Defend. Decent dueling. Okay, continue. Back up to Kurga. Let's see if we can get Kurga's favor again. Avoid the circles. This is like, what, the third, fourth time we've been here? Now, isn't it Eye, forehead, mouth, I think. Left eye. For some reason, we skip the nose, which is always strange to me. Huh. Stranger, you are not of my faith, whispers the god, and yet you have completed my ritual. How can that be? I have used my wits. The god laughs softly. My brother Pashna is the god of thieves and tricksters, but you are in my temple today. I will answer three questions if you have questions to ask. Take a moment. Tell me the spell for the gate. I know the order. Damn it. I cannot tell you the spell. Only the nobles know. Mulas, Shinva, Theta, and Lorag. I see from your face that you have already encountered the last of these, at least. Find the rest and the spell will be yours. The god waits for your next question. How are we going to find out the rest? What happens now? I mean, I have it, I just can't read it. Do I need to find somebody to read it? Yeah, I'm not really happy with this right now. Now we gotta deal with these again. Vic for First Noble. You're going the wrong way, the man observes. The fight is this way, and he points along the road back to town. There's a goblin army who will come up behind you. The man laughs. A goblin army in Kharé? I don't think so. Then his laugh changes to a glower. Don't you go spreading such lies. It's poor morale. It's true. The man laughs. No, because we won't be anywhere near here. We take the city tonight. With that, he whistles to his wolves and sweeps away into the night. You breathe a heavy sigh of relief. Okay. I'm not that relieved because we're going to die now because we're going to take rewinding again. You stride over to the gate. Do you know the spell to open this gate? Hold on. Let me check my stuff. Theta, Shinva, Lorag. Kroga's Grace. Gollum's Hide. Tumbler's Two. What was it again? Horrible. I should really just write it down and have it with my little thing. My little cheat sheet of spells. We want Shinva and then Lorak. So then we want lock made of golem's hide. Tumblers too sealed deep inside. I bid you portals open wide. It seems like it might be a whole line. You stand back to see what effect your lines have had. The voice has gone silent. It worked. I guess we did have the whole thing? I'm so happy right now, guys. You wait impatiently to see what will happen. Then the gate creaks. The tumblers drop and the wooden panels begin to move. The door is opening. Booming out, the voice declares, "The gate is under your control. But it is moving slowly. Looking over your shoulder, you see an army of goblins emerging from a well shaft, and they are racing toward you." I mean, I could put this to a vote, but we have an army of goblins. It'd be pretty stupid to, you know, fight an army of goblins. There's no one else here with me, except for the ghost of Lorag, and Lorag, the human, has proven not to be trustworthy anyway, so I don't think the ghost is going to help me slip through the gate. You rush through the gate into the backlands. Now, weren't we supposed to help the city? I didn't see a chance to do that. Piano North Gate. In the darkness around you, figures are moving, pouring towards the gate into the city. Inside, you see the goblins still coming. Wait. I thought the goblins came from the well. I thought they came from there. Oh my. The music is building in intensity. But here it says they're pouring towards the gate into the city. In the darkness around me. I'm gonna close the gate. Gate, you command desperately. Close. The gate obeys immediately, swinging shut like a trap. From the low hills around, red-faced marsh goblins are springing up and pouring toward the sealed gate like flies onto a fallen ox. They begin to scramble on top of one another, trying to bridge the wall with their own bodies. You know, I know I said I wouldn't fight the goblins. It says destroy the goblins. Can the gate help me with that? Let's give it a try. The goblins must be destroyed. As though on command, a ghostly figure forms in the air before you. It is Lorag. "You control the gate," the figure whispers. "Use it." "I don't know how," you shout back. The goblins are reaching the top of the wall now. Some have bows and are firing burning arrows into the forest around the gate. "You control the gate," the wizard shouts back. "Use it!" Try? It is hopeless. How can you use a magic you do not know? You close your eyes, feeling your anger and frustration rising. The hated goblins, this meddling specter, the long and difficult road behind, and the one still to come, all seem to bite into your very soul with wolf-like teeth. There is suddenly a terrible sound. The smell of burning. Are we praying goblins? You open your eyes. There's not a goblin in sight, just blackened grass around the gate, and black soot in piles on top of the wall. Or soot, rather. The ghost nods slowly to you. All the hatred of a whole city of thieves and liars and murderers stored for centuries, a little leaked out into the red eyes. The rest was waiting for this, for one strong of heart enough to use it. He gestures to the path ahead. Go. Be safe. The road is long. You nod and turn to go.
Wow. Cool.
From a short distance away, you look back to see the plain outside the gate is quite empty. Not a single marsh goblin remains. Not a single short sword or hooked pick. It is like they have been wiped from the surface of the earth. And inside Kharé, something similar must have occurred, as where there was a sound of clashing swords, there was now only silence. You have saved Kharé, a foul city perhaps, but not one whose citizens deserve to die by a goblin sword. But it has been at a cost to your strength. You turn your back. Your own road lies ahead, through the plains of Badubak and on towards Mampang. Yeah, not at the cost to my strength, because I believe I was at 20 max stamina at one point. The backlands await. You remember the words of the Sightmaster Sergeant as you left the outpost settlement. Once you have crossed the Cityport of Traps, you will enter the backlands. They say that day and night are controlled by forces other than the sun. And from Kharé, too, your progress will be watched.
Badubak.
Your journey across Kharé is complete. In the course of your journey, you saved the Cityport of Kharé from destruction, and your spirit guide was replaced by Korga, the god of grace. You played two games of Swindle Stones, losing them both. You learned the truth about what the crown does, a riddle about the sleepless ram, and that silver weapons harm the undead. You collected some magical artifacts, a cloth skullcap, two blimberry potions, one giant's tooth, and two sun jewels. Also, you found a bottle of bark essence and a tinderbox. You are still armed only with your original sword and have no rations and three gold pieces and a spellbook. Continue. The adventure continues in Sorcery 3, The Seven Serpents. I'm going to write that down. Now, I don't know if we are also saving to the disc as well, or we're only cloud saves there? I don't even know. Luleji. Awesome. Thanks so much for watching, guys. This is going to be a long episode. No vote necessary. Next week we'll be starting part 3. Serpent of whatever. I already actually have all 4 episodes, so... no need to worry about money situations. Anyway, thanks so much for watching and for participating, guys. So, yeah, let me know what you think, anyway, about how the story ended. Pretty sweet, I think. The $99 orchestra? Is that how much they were paid? $99? So, yeah, next week we'll continue with Chapter 3. And, yeah, the Seven Serpents, there you go. And votes will return. Eager to see what comes up next. First chapter was really short. This one was rather long. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next week.